official newspaper files of the early West record many stories of famous and notorious characters of that period. Doc Holliday, the Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde of the 80s, born in Valdosta, Georgia, of a fine southern family. Though a well-bred and well-educated dentist, he was forced to move west because of ill health and became a fatalistic, ruthless, and deadly killer.
Keep that rifle out of sight until we get a race out of him.
Hey, Tim. Looks like they want to have a race. Open up that throttle and I'll fire it up a bit.
Are you sure there's $80,000 coming through on that train?
Sure as we're sitting here, Doc. It's a special to Dodge City.
It's picking up speed. They're getting near the curve.
Through the mail car, there was nothing. Nothing. I thought you said there was $80,000 coming through.
I can't understand it, Doc. Billy said he saw the money put on the train at Pavo.
You know what this means? Every marshal, deputy, railroad detective in the territory is going to be on our necks. All for nothing.
But, Doc, Billy said...
Oh, shut up.
Let's get back to horses and separate. I'm gonna go back to town, and you better dig the biggest hole in Arizona and lay low. Come on, Ed.
When I rolled that one of our crack trains to Dodge City had been wrecked, and one of the trainmen was still alive, I was on my way. Frankie Adams, my associate, was already on the scene of the crime. My name is Matt Clark, railroad detective.
Hi, Sheriff.
Hi, Matt.
Hello, Frankie.
He's been shot. He's the only survivor.
Shot?
Yes, he's one of the train crew.
Is it all right to talk to him?
Oh, yes.
Do you know who shot you?
Outlaws. Stagecoach.
Did you recognize any of them?
No. Heard one called Doc. Doc said he was going back to town.
Doc. That's a strange name for an outlaw. Who are the medical men in these parts?
Well, outside of Dr. Williams here, there's the veterinary, Dr. Hayes, and a dentist by the name of Dr. John H. Holliday.
Well, we can eliminate this, Doctor. The trainman would have recognized him before he died. At least two possible suspects. It's a stab in the dark, but... Frankie, you may not know it, but you got a toothache and I got a sick horse. I'll see the vet and you see Doc Holliday. Let's go.
Well, let's take a look at that tooth. Which one's bothering you?
The one in the back, on the left side.
Open your mouth. Well, I don't see a cavity. I'll put a little medicine on it. That ought to ease the pain. How long you been in town?
Just passing through. As a matter of fact, I was supposed to take that train that was wrecked. Terrible thing, wasn't it?
Certainly was. When did you hear about it?
I read it in the local paper. Both the engineer and the fireman were killed. Ghastly thing. Poor families.
I can't understand who would deliberately shoot them down in cold blood. There, that ought to do it.
How much do I owe you?
No charge for a little thing like that, miss. I don't think you'll have any more trouble with that tooth. But if you do, come back and see me tomorrow.
Thank you very much, doctor. And Sheriff, he said that all the train crew were shot.
But nobody knows that except us and the outlaws who shot them. Everybody else in town thinks they were killing the train wreck. I've been asking a lot of questions around town, and everybody calls him Doc. Do you know anything about him, Sheriff?
Oh, not much more than you do. He has a reputation for being a gunfighter. Just started practicing dentistry here a few months ago. Says he came out for his health.
He must have something to do with that wreck.
I'm positive of it.
Well, Doc Holliday may be our suspect number one. We can't do anything about it unless we get proof. But I sure would like to know where he was during that wreck.
So would I. The trouble is, we have no eyewitnesses left that can identify him. They're all dead.
Frankie, you have an appointment with Doc Holliday tomorrow morning, don't you?
Well, he told me to come back if the tooth was bothering me.
Well, you may not know it, but it's bothering you. And you're going to keep that appointment with him tomorrow morning.
But I forgot which one it was.
Your left wisdom tooth.
Oh, yeah. Thanks.
See you later, Sheriff.
What are you doing in town? I thought I told you to get out of here and lay low and break up the gang.
Doc, I got the right information this time. That gold's coming through the day after tomorrow.
I don't care when it's coming through. Ever since that wreck, this town's been swarming with lawmen. They're suspicious.
You're not turning yellow, Doc.
Clanton, nobody calls me yellow.
I know you can outdraw me, Doc, but someday I'll catch on even terms.
Now, your even terms is with that dirty, lousy gang of yours behind you. Or waiting behind a rock. Now, get out of here. Go and hide in that closet.
I didn't like Frankie going up to Doc Holliday's office alone, but there was no getting around it. However, I meant to follow her as soon as possible and be at the door if anything went wrong.
Oh, hello. I'm terribly busy. Could you come back a little later?
I don't know. My tooth is awfully sore.
Say 10 o'clock, Miss... I'm sorry, what is your name?
Adams.
Miss Adams. 10 o'clock, then?
Fine.
Miss Adams? Oh, Miss Adams, you want to come on back? I find I do have time to take you. Open.
Oh!
I think I'd better pull that tooth just to make sure.
No, I...
Well, that's right, Miss Adams. We can replace it if you're going to be in town that long.
But I'm not. I'm leaving tomorrow.
What train are you taking?
I'll be on the stage. I'm not taking a chance on a train.
Oh, yes. The wreck. The one you read about in the local paper.
That's right.
You know, a funny thing, Miss Adams. When we were talking yesterday, you said you read about the wreck in the paper.
That's right.
You didn't read it in the paper. This is the first paper printed since the wreck. There's no mention of the disaster in last week's edition.
I probably overheard it in the store.
I don't believe you. What's wrong with your teeth? Now, what did you come here for?
Take a look at this, Doc.
A railroad pass. You work for the railroad.
The way she's been pumping you, she's probably a detective.
How much do you know? Come on, start talking.
Let me take her to the hideout. I'll make her talk.
Just hold on to her. I think I can make her talk right here.
You see these, Miss Adams? I'm gonna pull your teeth one by one until you start talking.
Keep your hands off of her.
I'll tell you later. Bring your deputies and come on.
Hey, Frank. You do. Come on.
The idea of you running out on me.
What did you want me to do? I couldn't kill this detective right in town.
What are you gonna do with her?
Billy!
Take this gal outside. Doc and I want to talk. We're gonna pull this robbery whether you like it or not.
They'll pin it on us if we don't kill the girl.
I don't mind having a reputation as a gunfighter, but I've never been mixed up in a cold-blooded murder. Every man I've ever killed, I've given a chance to go for his gun. And Ike, you're gonna let that girl go.
If you do, she'd be running to the nearest lawman. That would be Wyatt Earp. And tell everything. I made a mistake throwing in with you.
You pull that trigger, Wyatt will hunt you and your whole dirty gang down and kill you.
It's gonna come to a showdown with the Earps anyway. And it might as well start with you. Billy! Take the gal outside.
You saved my life, Miss Adams. I don't know for how long.
Break it down!
Track Holliday down. He's the only one knows where they took Frankie.
Did you get a good look at the man that grabbed Frankie?
Well, not too good, but he's ugly and got a big lantern jaw.
That could be Ike Clanton. Wyatt Earp was in town inquiring about him.
Is Holliday still a good friend of Earp's?
As far as I know, he still is.
I think I'll go to Tombstone and see Earp. He might know where Holliday hangs out.
Well, he won't believe it when you tell him that Doc Holliday's working with Clanton. They're bitter enemies.
Well, I'll see you, Sheriff. If anything turns up here, I'll be in Tombstone.
Give Wyatt my regards. We'll keep our eye open for Holliday.
Right.
Sorry, Miss Adams. This night air isn't doing me any good.
You want to ride a while?
Listen. Getting too dark to follow the trail anymore. Must be a coyote. Holliday's making a beeline straight to Tombstone. Call it the search. We're going to Tombstone. We'll get Wyatt Corral. Tell the rest of the boys. Are you tired?
No more than you are.
I've got to go to Tombstone and warn Wyatt that Ike's out to kill him in the morning.
Earp's a good friend of yours, isn't he?
Best.
That's funny. A wanted gunfighter and a famous marshal like Wyatt Earp should be so friendly.
Saved his life once. A drunken cowboy tried to shoot him in the back.
You know you're suspected of wrecking a train. Your friend will probably put you in jail.
They can't prove anything. Besides, Miss Adams, I'm sort of a fatalist. You take the cards the way they're dealt. Wyatt's got to be warned. Bye, Miss Adams.
Are you leaving me?
I'm sorry, the horse can't carry the two of us.
But I don't know where I am.
If the plans don't get me, I'll come back for you.
Stranger, what can I do for you?
I'm looking for Wyatt Earp.
Well, you found him.
I'm trailing Doc Holliday. I understand you're a friend of his.
Yeah, I am. Sit down.
Much obliged.
What kind of a scrape is Doc in this time?
He's wanted for questioning regarding the train wreck, and I'm filing a kidnap charge against him.
Doc wouldn't kidnap anybody.
We think Ike Clanton took Frankie Adams, another railroad detective. Doc might know where they've taken her. He was working with the Clantons.
Doc Holliday working with the Clantons?
You're under arrest, Holliday. Where's Frankie Adams?
Take it easy. Take it easy. I left her just outside of town. Wyatt, you old son of a gun, you... Well, don't seem too glad to see me, Wyatt.
I'm not. This man's a detective. And you're suspect number one in an attempted robbery. What's this I hear of you working with the Clantons?
You know better than that, don't you, Wyatt?
Lock him up till we bring the Clantons in.
Your gun, Doc. Over there. Hate to do this.
Well, I guess I'm just as safe here as I would be on the outside. Ike Clanton's been trailing me. He and his whole gang are just outside of town at the OK Corral, looking for trouble. They're coming to get both of us, Wyatt.
So they're in town for a showdown.
I'd like to go with you.
Give him back his gun. We'll need all the help we can get.
I'll get my brothers. You go to the saloon and deputize some of those cowboys. Come on, Doc.
Clayburn, you got here just in time.
Wyatt Earp and Holliday are at the marshal's office together. We're going to get them.
Get off the street. Under arrest, Clanton.
We arrived with help, the battle was over. Tom McLaurie dead, Frank McLaurie dead, Billy Clanton dead. The rest of the gang wounded and unable to continue. This was the end of the most famous feud in Western history. The fight at the OK Corral between the Clantons and the Earps.
I'm gonna take him to a doctor. Can you hold off filing charges until we can get him back on his feet?
Well, sure. I'm putting him in your custody.
Thanks, you'll find your partner 10 miles out on the north trail.
Thanks, Doc. I'll go get her.
Come on, Doc. Come on.
Frankie, this telegram just came in. Thought you might be interested. April 18th, 1885. Dr. John H. Holliday died last night of tuberculosis in the Glenwood Springs Sanitarium, Colorado. His condition was complicated by his recent severe gun wounds. Signed, Dr. H. L. Peterson, physician in charge. Well, that's that. I guess that closed the files on Doc Holliday. You know, Frankie, he had every opportunity when he started out. Good family, good education, a good personality. But instead of taking advantage of those good qualities, he fell by the wayside.
I imagine he'll go down in history as one of the West's most notorious gunmen.
Oh, by the way, the boss wants to see us.
About a new assignment?
Seems we were both late to work this morning. Let's go.